Well, tonight, Serena Williams takes the court at the U.S. Open to compete in what's expected to be the last major Grand Slam of her legendary career. Many consider Williams, who is now 40, the greatest tennis player of all time. And no one denies that she's changed the game. Let's take a look at the impact that she's had both on and off the court.
With each swing, each step, each day, Serena Williams inches closer to the end of an incomparable era of tennis. She's already taken home 6 titles here at the U.S. Open, but this time, she says, will likely be her last. Over her 27-year pro career, Williams has won 856 matches and lost just 154. That includes an astounding 365 major match wins, the most of all time, and 23 Grand Slam singles titles, the most in the Open era. Off the court, she has shattered barriers, battling racism and sexism, redefining beauty, and setting new bars for financial success, earning not only $95 million in career prize money, the most of any women's tennis player in history, but also superstar big brand endorsements. She has also repeatedly challenged the status quo, claiming her last major title while pregnant in 2017.
And Serena smashes Steffi's record. It's number 23.
A pregnancy that nearly killed her. Then she used her voice to raise awareness for Black maternal mortality. Writing in Elle magazine, quote, Black women are nearly 3 times more likely to die during or after childbirth than their white counterparts. Being heard and appropriately treated was the difference between life or death for me. I know those statistics would be different if the medical establishment listened to every Black woman's experience. For the next generation, like 18-year-old tennis star Coco Gauff, Williams set a standard to reach for.
If she had 23 Grand Slams and was a terrible person, I wouldn't consider her the GOAT. I think for me, what makes her the GOAT is her personality and all that she's done for off the court to fight for equality, to fight for young players like me.
Serena Williams was raised in Compton, California. Her father, Richard, coached her and sister Venus on public courts. Big things were expected from an early age. Here's Serena at 11.
I'd like to be a tennis player.
If you were a tennis player, who would you want to be like?
Well, I like other people to be like me.
3 years later, she turned pro. 3 years after that, she won her first Grand Slam title at the 1999 U.S. Open. She was just 17. Injuries threatened to derail Williams' career. An ankle sprain forced her to withdraw from the 2002 Australian Open. But within months, she was hoisting trophies again, winning the French Open, the U.S. Open, and Wimbledon, defeating big sister Venus in each of those finals. Serena Williams had solidified her place as the number one player in the world. And her impact on the game, says tennis legend Chris Evert, is undeniable.
You know, there's 2 things about Serena. I think the legacy about her game is she brought power, a new level of power into the game. And also Venus, too. The Williams sisters have brought power. They've brought fearlessness in on and off the court.
The Williams sisters became fierce opponents and dominant teammates, becoming the first sister duo to claim Olympic doubles gold in 2000, 2008, and 2012. But their success didn't shield them from blatant racism. After the crowd hurled racial slurs at the family during the 2001 Indian Wells tournament in California, Serena boycotted the event for 14 years. When she returned in 2015, she explained why in a Time magazine op-ed, writing, quote, Indian Wells was a pivotal moment for my story, and I am part of the tournament story as well. Together, we have a chance to write a different ending. Another ending now nears as Williams hints at her next chapter in life. On Friday in New York City, Williams, whose venture capital firm Serena Ventures has raised $111 million, rang the bell at the New York Stock Exchange, mere days before what's expected to be her final major tennis tournament.
I think that Serena has contributed probably more off the court than on the court. I mean, I look at her off the court, I look at her fearlessness, you know, body shaming to women of color, to mothers, you know, working. She's really spoken up for a lot of issues. I think the fact on the tennis court, she's brought a new level of power into the game, and so she's revolutionized power in women's tennis. I'd put her right up there with Muhammad Ali and Billie Jean King and Michael Jordan, and as far as superstar.
Let's delve more now into Serena Williams' incredible career and legacy with William C. Rhoden. He has long covered her, as well as her sister Venus and many other tennis greats. He's been writing about her accomplishments for the sports and culture website, Anscape. Bill Rhoden, welcome back to the NewsHour. Always good to have you here. We're talking about Serena's next chapter because of this essay she wrote in Vogue, but she didn't say retirement. She said transition. She said evolution. What does that mean to you? And what did you think when you read it?
Well, the first thing that got me was when she said the R word, because that terrifies me too. That's the thing that resonated with me. Just the idea of not doing something that you've been doing, in my case, since I was like 10 years old, and the idea of not retiring. And I know how terrifying it has to be for her to be 8 years old, to come from Compton, to become what I think, along with her sister, I've been doing this now for about 49 years. And I think without doubt, the story of Venus and Serena Williams is probably the greatest sports story in United States history, bar none. And for her to finally wake up one day and look at her daughter, say, you know what, I just don't want to do this anymore. I know that has to be hard. It has to be pulling at her heart. But if there's any solace, is that what she has accomplished for women, for Black women, for equity, I think at this point of our history is unparalleled. I think it's just, we're at the point now, it's still fresh, and words, although we're all wordsmiths, words can't really describe the impact that she has had at so many levels. You know, I think about, you know, my Black mother, my Black sister, my Black daughter, and what she's meant for them in terms of empowerment, in terms of confidence, and in terms of victory. You know, it's just... it's just such mixed emotions because I hate to see her go. Mm-hmm. I hate to see her go, but I'm so excited about these next chapters.
Bill, she is one Grand Slam title short of beating the record, Margaret Court's record of 24. Do you think there's any chance she ties that or breaks that before she says goodbye to
me? As we could identify this as journalists, we cheer for the story, right? the great story is that she finds one more magical moment at the U.S. Open, and we find her playing Saturday. I mean, what better way to go out than to win, to tie Margaret Court at the U.S. Open? I mean, that would just be unbelievable. Like, now I'm thinking as a journalist, and also with my heart, but that would be yet another movie.
Well, the big question, as you mentioned briefly, it's legacy, right? It is impact, both on the court and off. I mean, the game, if you just look at her impact on the game, it is different today than it was pre-Serena. Tell me about her impact just on the game of tennis.
Well, just, and Chris Everett mentioned this too, just the introduction of power. And Venus, by the way, I've got to say, Venus was sort of the precursor to that, because we had never seen anybody with that type of power before. Serena just took it to a whole nother level of just playing a pure power game. And I also think that we have to talk about the intimidation factor. And this was so liberating, I think, to women athletes, in that, hey, man, you know, you could get out there and you could sweat. You could be a sweat getter. Sometimes you could curse if you want to. And I think that was just so liberating. I think that her competitiveness is what sets her apart. She is just such a ferocious competitor. So I think that the power in combination with just being a ferocious competitor, I think, is really what has made her a timeless figure in that sport.
You had this great line about her in your latest piece. I'll quote from you here. You said she's been the sports equivalent of Beyonce and is her generation's Aretha Franklin, singing loud and long and leaving no uncertainty about the way she felt. What did you mean by that?
That's, you know, if you've ever been to, I was fortunate to see Aretha and Beyonce kind of out the side of my eye. But with Aretha, Aretha was just this natural force. You know, she's just this natural force of nature. And you leave a concert from her and you have, there's no mistaking how she felt about life. And I think that with Serena, she left all her emotions on the court. There was no, I mean, I know she's probably not proud of this moment, but when she confronted that poor line judge and she told her what she was going to do with that racket, how she was going to stick it down her throat. And Serena's one of the sweetest people you'd want to meet off the court. But there, anybody at the court side, they're like, yikes, you know. So she, you know, you after a Serena Williams match, and I'm sure if it happens tonight, you will know exactly how she feels. She's not going to prettify it. She's not going to sugarcoat it. And that's what I love about her, is just that she really leaves. It's just so raw, and she leaves it on the court. I just think it's just what she's done for that sport is phenomenal. And I will say, it's probably not going to happen, but there should be statues of Venus and Serena in Australia at the French Open, in Wimbledon at the U.S. Open. There should be statues at each one of those Grand Slams for what they have done for this sport. I think that, like I said, right now it's kind of hard for us to take the measure of because it's so new and fresh, but it's just immeasurable.
Well, I think you and I will both be among the millions watching and waiting to see what happens as she closes out this remarkable chapter. William C. Rhoden of Anscape joining us tonight. Thank you so much for your time.
My pleasure.
And one more note. As you might expect, Serena intends to go out in style beginning tonight. She'll be wearing a figure skating inspired outfit for comfort and freedom of movement, featuring 6 layers, one for each of the titles she's won in Flushing Meadows. But that is not all. Her sneakers will feature 400 hand set diamonds and solid gold elements too. Going out in style indeed. We'll expect nothing less from Serena Williams.